I woke up in the morning with a sharp pain in my leg, and I could not stand up. Finally, when I was able to walk again, I went down to my mom's room and said, in a joking way, like, I feel like I have a blood clot in my leg. And so she gets concerned, and I'm just like, I'm kidding, like, it hurts. And then went back, got ready for school, and then we were in my geometry class, and I was trying to stand up, and I couldn't. And I was trying to keep my left hand up onto the table just to set it somewhere because it was just drooping, and I couldn't move it. And I was starting to get emotional at that point. I said, I feel like I'm having a stroke.
We were dispatched by 911 to Boyne Falls Community Schools for a 14-year-old that could not move her side.
The ambulance came in shortly right behind me. And when he came in, he picked up her arm and it fell right back down. And then it was like, oh, something's very wrong with my daughter.
I've been a paramedic since 2004. I've been doing EMS since 1997, and I've never witnessed a pediatric stroke.
The ambulance open and they transport her in. It's just like a whirlwind. You go here, they go there, and the emotions are running pretty high at that moment.
One of our pediatric neurologists, Dr. Kruger, received a call from McLaren Potoski saying they had a child who maybe had some stroke-like symptoms. We had scans that indicated that the right middle cerebral artery was blocked in her brain.
We lost a child 2.5 years ago. It was kind of a scary moment to think.
Yeah, like can't lose another child.
I was like, God, you can't take two of my kids from me. It's like, it's a scary moment.
Within 15 minutes of coming to the hospital, she was rushed to the surgery.
The pediatric intensive care unit doctor and the neurologist whisked her away to our Siemens artist Q room where we did the thrombectomy procedure. We're able to successfully retrieve the clot and restore blood flow to near normal to the right side of her brain. And for her, we did that entire procedure in about 15 minutes.
We were sitting there and praying and holding each other and just waiting for the news. And the news was getting better at this point.
We did see that she had a small blood clot in a vein in her leg and that she had had a hole in her heart that was pushing blood across her heart. So we believe that she had a clot break off from her leg, cross over her heart, and likely went up into her brain and caused her stroke.
When we left the hospital, the doctors said, live as normal as you can. Her mother was a little more scared that, you know, should you be doing that? Are you sure? Are you okay?
I watched her sleep. I watched her breathe. It was kind of like watching a newborn again. We also had a surgery to close the hole in the heart, and the surgery was performed on Valentine's Day, which is a perfect day to fix a broken heart, in my opinion.
Pediatric stroke is actually quite rare. And for stroke in general, so much depends on how quickly people get to us and how quickly we're able to help. You know, time is brain, that really means something, because when you get to us, we can help you.
Strokes do happen in young people, and it's very important to take those symptoms seriously because the outcome could have been much worse.
I learned so many things from having a stroke at 14. And in my case, time saved me.